Hi students, welcome to Smarter Everyday Overlearning. Dear students, I've been explaining the classes for you, Chemical Bonding and the Molecular Structure chapter for your NEET series. And dear students, up to now 30 questions completed for your NEET series. And those who didn't see those classes, that link I'll provide for you in the description. You can go through those classes. Okay students, let's start our today's session. Chapter wise solutions from the chapter Chemical Bonding and the Molecular Structure. Questions, here we have the question number 31. Let's start our today's session, students. Right, which of the following pairs of examples here, what we have, which of the following pairs is isostructural, that is having the same shape? Okay students, this is the question. We have shape and the hybridization, BCl3, BrCl3 and NH3NO3-. There are some options given, and here let's see, you have to know one by one. See, the first one is BCl3, it has sp2 hybridization. Dear students, only basing upon the structure and basing upon the molecular formula, how can we find out the hybridization? Already in our previous video, that class was completed, students. You can go through that class also. I'll provide that link for you. And there is a simple trick to find the hybridization for the molecule. Basing upon that, I am doing here BCl3, that is sp2 hybridization. And then the shape is, dear students, trigonal planar. Basing upon this hybridization. And let's see, BrCl3 hybridization should be sp3d. The compound has T shape. Then the compound is T shaped compound. And students, for NH3 here, the hybridization should be sp3 and the shape is pyramidal. Okay, and for NO3-, the structure trigonal planar and the hybridization is sp2. Trigonal planar. And students, for here NF3, that is sp3 hybridization, pyramidal shape. This is also pyramidal, just like NH3, pyramidal. And for BF3, hybridization is sp2 and this is trigonal planar. Trigonal planar, right? BF4- ion, hybridization is sp3 and this is tetrahedral in shape. Tetrahedral, you have to remember all of these, otherwise by seeing the molecular formula you have to identify which type of hybridization is involved in that. NH4+, here we have sp3 hybridization and this is also same tetrahedral in shape. Okay students, now let's see which one is the correct one. Pairs isostructural, that is having the same shape and the hybridization, means option D. We have to finalize it. Why? Because sp3 and sp3 both are having tetrahedral in shape, right? And let's go for next one. Bond order of 1.5 is shown by the molecules. Here some ions they have given and molecule they have given. In these 1.5, for which ion, for which molecule we will get the answer. Let's do it basing upon that molecular orbital energy level diagram. These are the electronic configurations of O2 molecule and O2-2- ion and O2- and O2+. Here students, this is the complete electronic configuration basing upon molecular orbital energy level diagram. Sigma 2s2, sigma star 2s2, these are antibonding orbitals and the bonding orbitals here, and basing upon them you have to find out the bond order. Half into bonding orbitals minus antibonding orbitals, if we do these type of calculation we will get these type of answers here. And this is 2 for O2 and O2-2-1, O2-1.5, here O2+2.5. these are the bond orders. Now let's see the question. In this question students, 1.5 is shown by these molecules, then the answer is option B here, what we have for O2 minus, that is the answer 1.5. Here we calculated basing upon these electronic configuration students 1.5, and for O2 plus, here O2 plus we have the answer 2.5. So these are all the bond orders what we have calculated here basing upon these electronic configurations. Okay, then the correct answer is option B, 1.5 O2 minus. Let's see the next one. Which of the following species contains 3 bond pairs and 1 lone pair around the central atom? Okay, here some options we have: H2O, BF3, NH2 and PCl3. In H2O students, oxygen is the central atom, here oxygen, and here boron, and here nitrogen, here phosphorus. Okay students, let's see one by one. These are the structures for H2O and BF3 and NH2 minus and PCl3. Here students, for H2O molecule, there are lone pair of electrons upon the oxygen. Then we can calculate that 2 bond pairs. Why? Because here 2 electron pairs are combined here. Then we can say 2 bond pairs. And what about lone pairs here? See, there are single electrons without participating in any bond. Those are 2 lone pairs. Okay, this is about H2O. And let's see for BF3 here, fluorine atoms. And here there is no lone pairs. Why? Because all the electrons are involving in the bond formation. So there is no lone pair of electrons. So that we can say 3 bonds are formed here than 3 bond pairs of BF3. And students, for NH2 minus, option C, NH2 minus, upon the nitrogen, here and here also 2 bond pairs, and students 2 lone pairs. Here 2 bonds only formed here, those are 2 bond pairs. Why? Because here 2 pair of electrons can combine. And for PCl3, here Cl, Cl and Cl, 3 Cl chlorine atoms. And students, upon the P, phosphorus, there is only 1 lone pair of electron. We can say 3 bond pairs for this, and only 1 lone pair here. And students, see the question. Species contains 3 bond pairs and 1 lone pair. 3 bond pairs and 1 lone pair, that is PCl3. Like this, we can calculate the answer. Okay, right. Let's see the next one. The pair of species which the same bond order is. So for this question, you need to find out the bond order basing upon that molecular orbital energy level diagram, not Euler chart. Okay, right. Now let's see one by one for all of these. For O2 2 minus, the bond order is 1. Okay, why? Because in the previous question I have explained to you, in the previous one, like this, O2 2 minus, these are the antibonding orbitals and the bonding orbitals. This is the bond order. For O2, 2 here we got it, and for O2 minus 1.5, for O2 plus there are 15 electrons and 2.5. This is the stability and the increasing order. Okay, basing upon this, I am writing the bond orders here. For O2 2 minus we have only 1, and for O2 plus we have 2.5, that is the bond order. And for NO also 2.5, and for N2 that is 3, and B2 that is 1, the bond order. And for NO plus, that is 3, CO 3, O2 here 2.0. And students, what is the answer? Same bond order. Then what we have here, same bond order 2.5. This is same bond order here also 3, same bond order. Then the option is, if you check the options here, and for this option A, O2 2 minus and B2, these are having the same bond order, right? Let's go for next one. During change of O2 to O2 minus ion, the electron adds on which of the following orbitals? Pi star orbital, pi orbital, sigma star orbital, sigma orbital. Okay, students, for this question also you need to write for O2 and O2 minus ion electronic configuration basing upon molecular orbital energy level diagram. Let's see, already we have this for O2 here. This is the electronic configuration, students. Basing upon this, bonding orbitals are 8. Here we got it 2, 4, 6, 7, 8, and antibonding orbitals are 4 here. Okay, students, this is about O2, and let's see right here we have bonding orbitals and the antibonding orbitals. Thus the incoming electron will enter in pi star 2px pi star 2px to form O2 minus. Okay, this is the configuration of O2 molecule, and students, the incoming electron will enter here in pi star 2px to form O2 minus ion. Okay, now answer is option A, pi star orbital. This is the orbital, pi star orbital. Okay, let's go for next one. 4 diatomic species are listed below. Identify the correct order in which the bond order is increasing in them. This is the question. Here some options they have given. Dear students, we have to find out diatomic species and their bond order. Here diatomic species are diatomic species, and here the bond order, and here students NO and O2 minus, C2 minus, helium He2 plus. For these the bond orders basing upon this type of electronic configuration. For NO the bond order is 2.5, and for O2 minus that is 1.5, C2 minus 3.0, and He2 plus 0.5. these are the bond orders, and thus increasing order, basing upon these the increasing order, let us find out, students. See the first one, He2 plus less than O2 minus less than NO, C2 minus, right? This is the answer for this, and the correct one is here. You can see option D. Option D is the correct one. Let's go for next question. Which of the following has the minimum bond length? Minimum bond length. Here we did already the bond order calculation for these ions and this O2 molecule. Let's see for this O2 molecule, and these are all ions, the electronic configuration and the bond order. Then we can discuss which one has the minimum and the maximum bond length. This is the configuration. Basing upon this, we need to find out the bond order. Half into 8 minus 4, that is 2. Why? Because bonding orbitals and the antibonding orbitals basing upon this electronic configuration. And students, like this only for O2 plus and O2 minus, and the next one O2 2 minus, we can calculate. These are the bond orders basing upon this type of electronic configuration. As bond order increases, for suppose bond order increases, then bond length is decreases. Then we can say bond length is decreases. That means bond order is directly proportional to the bond length. If it is increases, the bond length is decreases, and the bond length is increases, automatically the bond order is decreases. Okay, these two are directly proportional to each other. Now the option A is the correct one. Least minimum bond length is O2 plus. Here you can observe, here students, for O2 we have 2, and for O2 plus 2.5, for O2 minus 1.5, here for O2 2 minus we have only 1. These are the bond orders. Least one is Let's see the next question, students. Which of the two ions from the list given below that the geometry that is explained by the same hybridization of orbitals NO2 minus, NO3 minus, NH2 minus, NH4 plus and HCN minus. Like these some ions they have given and we have to find out which one is the correct one. The geometry and the same hybridization. Here students, for these all of these atoms you have to find out ions and the type of hybridization, right? Type of hybridization. Here students, what are the ions we have? We have to list it out. NO2 minus and NO3 minus, NH2 minus and NH4 plus, and the last one is HCN minus. These are the ions we have here. And what about these hybridizations? Let's do it basing upon this molecular structure and this formula. Sp2 hybridization for NO3 minus, also sp2, NH2 minus, that is sp3, and here also sp3, and HCN, that is only sp. Okay, now the answer is option A, NO2 minus and NO3 minus. Here these two have the same hybridization and the geometry also same, students, except this, right? And let's go for next question. The correct order of increasing bond length. Here we have CH, CO, CC and C double bond C. Here options also they have given. Let's see, increasing order of bond length is, for these we can write the bond order here. Sorry, this is the bond length picometers. And students, for C double bond C, that is 134 pm. And for CO 141, and for C single bond C, that is 154 pm. And this is the bond order, sorry, increasing bond length, that is less than, right? And you have to remember all these bond length values, then only you can identify the increasing and the decreasing order of the bond length, students. Let's go for next one. Which of the following structures is the most preferred hands of lowest energy for SO3? Lowest energy. Here the last question for this today's session, students. Here let's see. Option A, SO3, these are all the structures we can identify. And the lone pair of electrons, the electrons which are not involving, not participating in the bond, also we can identify. Here the maximum number of covalent bonds we can count. Here see, 1, 2, 3, 4 covalent bonds here, and here students only 3. And for option C, here 4, these are the 4 bonds, and here you can see 3, 4, 5, 6. Okay, and option D, without having any doubt we can say the answer is the maximum number of covalent bonds are present in this option in SO3 molecular structure. These are all around this oxygen atom, lone pair of electrons, and here these are bond pairs and these are lone pairs. Now the option D is the correct one. Okay students, this is about our today's session. Some solved examples from the chapter chemical bonding and the molecular structure. If you have any doubt in this session, you can convey your doubt in the comment session. If you like this class and if you understand this class, you can subscribe to my channel for my further updates. Thank you so much. Thanks for watching.